Hello and welcome to UGC Highlander. I am Sunny Starmir here with Banana Man with John on stream. And we are excited today to bring you Tourette's Chess Club versus It's Mostly About the Gibbous. Banana Man, how are you doing today?
I am rather excited, Mia. This match is lining up to be a great one. How about you?
Oh yeah, I'm looking forward to see the final match in our division be played. This is a UGC steel match on Sea Gullywash Final 1. This is the tiebreaker map for the finals, which was played on Monday. On Monday, both Tourette's Chess Club and It's Mostly About the Gibbous played Koff Lakeside and PL Bomb Blitz Pro. It's Mostly About the Gibbous won Lakeside 4-0 comfortably, and Tourette's Chess Club won Bomb Blitz 2-0.
So do you want to give a quick rundown of the rosters? On Tourette's Chess Club, we have on Scout, we have Steve. On Soldier, we have Japter. On Pyro, we have Scissors. On Demoman, we have Yoshi. On Heavy, we have Sprayer. Appropriate name there. Engineer, we have Zoob. On Medic, we have Azadelwelf. I'm not sure how he wants me to pronounce that. On Sniper, we have Para. And on Spy, we have Kazool.
Alright, for It's Mostly About the Gibbous, we have MJB on Scout. We have Special K there on Soldier. Hench is on Pyro. Damn Easy is on Demoman. Lazy Shy Guy is on Engineer. Kippy is on Medic. Nickel is on Sniper. And Wilbo is on Spy.
Very talented rosters.
Yeah.
So are they getting word that we can go underway? Oh, it appears that It's Mostly About the Gibbous have actually dropped a player. So we'll have to wait for them to come back in.
Yeah, we might have to wait a while. In the double elimination playoffs, It's Mostly About the Gibbous won the upper bracket and Chess won the lower bracket. This means that Gullywash is It's Mostly About the Gibbous's pick. What do you think of Gullywash as a map, Banana Man?
I think it's probably more suited for Six's play than Highlander. But we've seen some interesting strategies coming out of teams on this map because nothing's really cut in stone at the moment, so be interested to see what each team decides to do.
I've got to say, out of the three 5CP maps, or 4CP maps overall, this season's UGC Highlander, Gullywash has to be my favourite. Probably because the other ones were really abhorrent, in my opinion. But I guess it's a personal opinion.
As a map, I like what the mapmaker's done to sort of shape up the 5CP sort of brand by trying to limit the size of choke points and stuff, but still does tend to get a bit choky here and there.
Yeah, the thing I like about Gullywash is it's a much smaller map than other 5CP maps. The distance from mid to last is considerably shorter. Because for other maps, say Croissant, or it's probably best seen in Process, it does get really like horrible trying to play a Six's map. But with Gullywash, it's sort of a lot more viable for Highlander than a lot of other 5CP maps.
Yeah. The mid fight in particular is very spaced out and is almost perfect for Highlander.
Yeah, how do you think teams are gonna push? Well, you can, there are about two pushes for the mid fight on Gullywash. You can either push your choke, or you can push up via your big door and try and hold their choke.
Yeah. Well, in the past, we've seen soldiers doing work on these mid-fights, so I think it's really going to come down to who's got the better DM and who's the earlier bomber to deny some area from these soldiers and demo men.
So, What players are you really looking forward to watching on here, Banana Man? I personally am looking out for the sniper on It's Mostly About the Givers, Nickel. He used to play for a silver team once. He moved down and plays for IMATG. He's really good. He's probably going to be really dominant on this map since it's a very sniper friendly map. It's got
Yeah.
some pretty sweet sight lines.
We'll have to see what Para for Chess Club can do to counter it. But definitely the sniper on sniper action is going to be crucial for getting good pushes out on this map.
Yes.
As a heavy, what do you think about trying to protect your medic on this map?
It is a pain in the ass.
Ha.
Because it's a sixes map, and you do get a lot of soldiers who play Highland who also have sixes experience. I mean, like, everyone likes to like experiment and dabble in it a bit. And unfortunately, there are so many horrible hiding spots. Like on either side of choke, there are ledges where a soldier can just hide. So each time I have to look up, and like if I'm not sure if the soldier is dead or not, I have to like look up and
Yeah.
check. Which is horrible because as soon as I go out of choke as a heavy, it's just so massive. There's gonna be a really douchebag sniper on the other side watching you choke. But it's preferable to other 5 CP maps, definitely, because of how small it is. I usually run like the GRU on here though, because I'm just like too lazy to walk really slowly. Although not like again, like I said, 5 CP, not the favorite game mode of heavy weapons
Well,
players. What do you think of it as an engineer?
as an engineer, well, just equip the Wrangler and you just get easy kills, really, on a map like this.
Yeah, I can kind of see what you mean. You've got such huge sight lines, they can just put it on one end of the map and wrangle it to the other side and just piss off a
Yeah.
heck of a lot of people, including myself.
Oh, we all know how much you hate mini sentries, Mia.
The technical proper name for it is a faggot sentry. You've got to get
Faggot
it right,
sentry.
Nana.
Okay. That gonna have to get beeped out or something, just in case?
I believe we have some
Heads up!
EU Steel All-Stars in here and some nominees. I know that Scissors is sorry for Tourette's Chess Club there on blue. He it is second spot for All-Star Pyro, so he should be interesting to watch.
Oh, of course, Notorious Hot being first place in that from TC.
I heard he got votes just because of his awesome accent, and I wholeheartedly back
Yeah.
and agree with that.
I genuinely think that the All-Stars should be made up purely of Frenchmen.
I would cast that. I would actually like.
I would
Oh
just
man,
hop
that'd
in
be the
their
best.
comms and just sit
Yeah.
there and just relax.
It'd be amazing.
It would.
We've also got Kippy, the medic for It's Mostly About the Gibbous, tagged up as IAATG. As you know, the Gibbous community was comprised of three competitive teams in the EU. Now they've sort of amalgamated into one team, which is It's Mostly About the Gibbous. He's an all-star medic as well. So, should be hoping for some good work from him. I've heard words that Chess Club are having some roster issues. The main engineer and heavy are on vacation. This means, yep, I know, you do not want to lose an important class like a heavy.
No. Oh yeah. Coming from the main heavy.
Oh, come on, heavy's important, you know. I gotta
Yeah.
babysit the medic.
Now, heavy, especially on a map like this, which is primarily close quarters, it's incredibly important.
Anyway, I've heard that their main medic, who is a usually sprayer, has actually gone heavy. Which shouldn't be too much of a problem because, you know, heavy medics have the sort of the same sort of game sense, so you sort of have to understand one class to be good at the other, and vice versa. Their sub sniper, Zaub, has also taken engineers. Is it Zaub or is it Zoob?
I'm pretty sure it's open to discussion, that name.
Zaub has gone engineer, and their sub medic, as a dire wolf, or tagged up here as Azza, to make our lives a bit easier for casting, is a medic. So, it already, like, isn't looking too good for Chess Club, considering that, like, Gully Wash was also, it's mostly about the Gibbous's pick. In the meanwhile, it's mostly about the Gibbous do have the whole roster here.
Yeah. I'm gonna turn you into colored rain. Well, you know, you'd think that people would stop real life for video games, but apparently it doesn't happen. Heads
up. Oh man, you know, I would actually, if I was in the EU Steel Finals, I would actually be on the fence as to whether to go on holiday or stay and play them. God, that sounds terrible, doesn't it?
No, we're all thinking the same thing. Don't worry about it. Just type in Steam chat, everyone, your predictions for this match.
Yep, if we can see what people want.
Yeah. Oh, we've got, it's mostly about the Gibbous, 5-1, there.
Oh, we've got, a chest from someone called MyPack.
Damn easy to go hooge, right there. Just got to win, very close game.
Easy being the man, for it's mostly about the Gibbous, if I am
correct. I have heard good things about him.
Yeah, he works really well with his heavy, because Breakfast JR is quite an aggressive heavy, and Damn Easy is, in comparison, plays a more passive damage dealing demo. Allows Breakfast to mop up, which is which shows really good confusion between the players. Got TFT YouTuber, Magical Killer Cow, predicting a chess club win, 5-4.
Chess club for UGC Plastic. Optimistic, well, there that from was Kippy.
Prediction from the medic from IMATG, so call that bias. I would call that bias.
We've got, definitely taken stats into consideration when making that prediction.
I don't think there's a UGC Plastic. I have a feeling there isn't that division, so
nonsense.
we've got Cox, the soldier from PvP, predicting a 5-4 close game to IMATG.
And I'm getting Steam messaged.
So the match should be starting soon. I heard that a player from It's Mostly About the Gibbous is restarting, so hopefully he should be back with us soon, otherwise the match will start a tad late.
Yeah. Oh no.
Why don't we...
Damn Richard Branson. Yeah. They can't. So it looks like I'm just talking to no one.
So it looked like you were talking to yourself. Yes,
right, GG. I'm actually mad. There you go. You heard it here first, kids. I'm mad.
Right. Let's look over some of the logs for some of the Monday games. I'm looking at the log for Koth Lakeside, which was IMATG's pick for Monday, and it looks like their heavy breakfast JR did a heck of a lot of work there. 4.1 KAD, so shows it's very strong. However, Yoshi for Tourette's Chess Club, he got like a 2.6 KD. He dealt a lot of damage. But I have a feeling the heavy husky couldn't finish a cleanup.
Yeah. I mean, it's an important combo between the Demoman and Heavy.
Yeah, you've got to get the chemistry right between them. As for kills on Lakeside, you've got the three massive power classes for IMATG at the top of the board with 41, 31, 31, and that would be Breakfast JR, Amuzi and Nickel, the heavy demo and sniper. It's not really surprising, but I would say that they were like some of the best players on IMATG after scrimming both teams in the past.
So what are your predictions for this match, Mia?
I'm trying to keep an open mind. I know Chess Club are having some roster issues and there isn't, you know, this isn't their like map pick, but in the silver finals on Monday, the losing team did lose like their picks but win the other team's pick, so you know.
Yeah.
Could surprise us.
It's gonna be interesting nevertheless.
Yeah, I'm being told in stream chat to go and make a prediction. I'd say I like both teams equally. They've got some really nice people on them, but I think that Gibbous might just edge this. I don't know, how about you, Banana Man?
Well, it being Gibbous's pick, I'm inclined to go for them. But it's really, really open to anyone on a map like this.
Yeah, I have a feeling that a Special K6's experience might give him the edge in the soldier battle on this.
Yeah, well, 6's players do tend to have an advantage on this map.
Yeah, but Steve has shown that he's a stronger scout, because if you look at the logs from Monday's match, he does get more frags than his other scout.
Yeah.
So, did you play Gullywash? Did you guys get to play it? Or...
No. Multiple Orgasms didn't get to play Gullywash.
Oh man, we had to play Gullywash. Like, it was... It was a nice match again, like sniper focused. Not my favorite. Right, IMATG are still having problems where they cannot get their spy in. Technically, by UGC rules, they technically by UGC rules, Chess Club can force a start right now because it's coming up to half.
If they defaulted, so that was still allowed.
But I think they're still waiting, but just getting incredibly impatient.
Yeah.
Right, Gullywash is played first team to 5 caps, so whoever has the most caps after 2 halves. The first half is played the first team to fall or when the time runs out, and second half is playing whichever team achieves 5 total caps, again when time runs out. If both halves end and the scores are tied, there's a third decider half where it's the first one to get a final cap.
Yeah.
And if in off chance that after 3 whole halves, still no cap and scores are tied, it's just a death match where it's the first one to cap mid and no one can leave spawn after they die. But that is incredibly unlikely. The last player for Gibbous has joined the server.
So we should be underway fairly soon.
Yes, we apologise for the delay.
It's really out of our control. But it's Mia's fault, so yeah.
It's Mia's fault, huh?
Yeah.
Oh man. Like, just, I would love to, like... I would, like, totally love to make the players come on time. My voice would hurt a heck of a lot less.
Just got about 3 Lucozades next to my desk, so I'm raring to go.
Oh! Wilbur has come in, apologised for internet problems, and one of the teams has readied up. So, literally starting in time.
Yep.
Oh,
I'm really raring to go here.
Alright, I'm looking at Turret's chess club. Their soldier, that's Japta's, whipping the team to mid.
Really, and fast rollout out of
the combo Yoshida. Is going up through big door. In the meanwhile, the combo for IMATG there on red are doing the exact same thing.
Oh, I really like the spacing that chess club have got right now.
Whoa, Nickel and Lazy Shy Guy, the engineer and the sniper, go down fast in the mid fight. That is really important.
Yeah, a few late picks coming in for Gibbous here.
Wow, numbers are about even. Ubers are about even. Combos are looking at each other.
I think that's a crits out of chess club. Yeah, it is. Here comes the crit rockets.
Whoa, crit rockets are right on the edge.
Oh, but the Uber's been popped off, and what's 3x0?
Yeah, but at the moment it's mostly about the Gibbous have more dominant positioning, and yeah.
That was very well played on the mid from them. Just almost baited and went back in. That's
yep.
A really nice play.
Turret's chest club are only one up. They've only got para, the sniper. IMATG need to move fast, and
yeah,
they can cap you. Yep, you've already got Stout going there. Para is about dies to MJB or Menju's Black, which is a very politically correct name. you have the combo for Gibbous holding up top.
Oh, Soldier getting aggressive on the mid there, not quite getting a pick.
Oh, that would be Special K for you. He's a really good jumper, unfortunately for me. you've got the
Red combo in Riverside here.
Yep, along with their Pyre and their Demoman, they've almost got Uber, whereas the Azure went down there to headshot from Nico.
Here comes the Uber.
They pop. Chapter runs in.
Oh, with a bonk scale, the point can't stop it. Pretty fast round there. I'm going to watch the chess club guys on the rollout.
Wow, yeah, Nico's pick of the medic there really helps his team push in.
Yeah. Yoshi deciding not to take the final jump there. Still arose.
He wants to play more passive because I believe Chess Club are still running crits and they do not need the demo man to die.
No, that would be a disaster.
Oh, oops. Turret's chest club are 3 down, and
Gibbous have been forced right back into their big door here.
Yep, Gibbous lost their Devilman damn easy, so that's a heck of a lot of spam they lost, and Turret's chest club
and
managed
out again.
Cap mid. Chess up.
Oh, Spy getting caught out there. Cause all. But getting away nice safely.
Currently have 100% crit.
Soldier getting aggressive on top of Asa there, but not quite getting the pop out of him. I mean, it's a crit, so it'd be no point anyway.
You can see the blue combo from Chess pushing in through Big Door right now, and in the meanwhile, the red combo held really far back. They're held at their choke with the Demoman, which is empty. And one
but that wrangled mini sentry just shutting the pushes down. Even the slight aggression is getting shut down by it.
Well, you've got both combos at red choke right now. They're trying to spam each other out, get a pick before they can push in. I mean, here currently
coverage.
Three down. This would be a good time for Chess to pop in. Oh, and they do.
Oh, they come.
They have Uber. Just popping Uber, the red Uber is popped to counter.
Quite
wow,
a lot of
Chess
players dropping there though for Chess Club.
That was a really adequate flashing.
Oh,
and
almost a wipe
wow.
out of Chess Club there.
Then
can
again,
Para get a hero pick right now?
Para is the only guy left up. Yo, just gets the engineer. He gets the engineer and he gets out and he gets counter sniped there by Nickel. This position gets called out. This is looking really bad. Chess Club.
See how fast they can move back out and just try and get on top of the second. But already a defense set up there from Chess Club.
Wow, you've got their heavy weapons guy on top there. Yep, you've got a rank of mini sentry watching Big Door and
aggression
Nickel.
Out of Special K forcing quite a lot of people back.
Nickel is trying to push through Big Door. In the meanwhile, you've got the combo from Gibbous along with the Demo and the Pyro pushing up through Choke. Yep, Kippy has a first advantage right now.
Oh, was there a backup going on?
There was a backup going on by Special K, the soldier. Oh, the Uber gets popped
gets
in
shut down by the faggot sentry.
As the Dalworth is really out of position. He's on really low health, getting attacked by the Pyro from mostly about the Gibbous, and he goes down.
Oh, man.
That is a lot of capture time on the point.
I guess you could say damn easy. And that's the only pun I'm going to be making today.
Wow, and that is a 2-0 from IMATG. Wow, that was really fast. That was really good work there by Breakfast. He was really impressive with clean up picks at the end.
Just knew where to be at what time.
Yep,
looks like damn easy was slightly faster than Yoshi out there. On the mid fight.
You've got a slightly different rollout and a mid fight. Both heavies are now at their own chokes.
Yeah.
Numbers are fairly even for
both teams. It looks like Gibbous have the position advantage though. The engineer coming in on the flank taking down Para. So I like to see engineer using their shotgun.
Both mid fights are really close, but IMATG seems to be edging this third one over. Kippy is building Uber heck of a lot faster than Azur is, and Tourette's chest pop.
Oh, there's a force pop out of Asa there.
Yeah,
and Gibbous gonna come straight back in.
Yep, Kippy there holding that Uber by the choke.
Force out of Japta, jumping from below.
That was a really good force.
Don't think they want to use it then either. Oh, it looks like Japs is going to come back in and they've just completely forgotten about him. He's got a free pick on the medic. Nice surf in there.
Right, it looks like IMHG have to go out. It looks Chess Club have better positioning. And they did
nice,
lose the carry heavy.
Steve just running in, just getting a pick on Kippy there.
Wow, this should mean that Azur will have a... Never mind, he goes down. As it goes down, so no Uber advantage for Threat Chess Club. Our control point has been captured. If I'm correct, the medic should spawn at the same time. Yep, they do, and so Ubers are going to be fairly even, unless Kippy carries on with his incredibly fast building.
Oh, look at that!
Even though Ubers lost the combo, they still managed to hold on to mid. So that was a really
It would be nice to see some a bit more aggression out of Chess Club there to really push that point.
You've got the blue combo holding up on point right now, and you've got the red combo trying to push him through choke.
The scout is really causing problems with his bomb.
Yeah, he's quite an annoyance.
He is, he's like that fly in your room who you can't get rid of.
Oh, whoa, Kippy pops crit, Azure doesn't die to crits, but dies to backstab there from Wilbo. Wow, Chess Club are currently only 3 up, they've only got their soldier
only
head.
Only 3 up
scout.
For Gibbous though.
Wow. That was really good cleanup there by Chapter and Sprayer. So,
wow, the mini sentry just denying everything on the point.
Yep, we are seeing double wipes from both teams.
That was. It's not what you want to see when trying to entertain viewers, but.
You got Steve there trying to get some sort of time on mid, but gets denied by a scout and a
Jack
pirate.
Oh, going underneath here. Can we play onto the medic? No. Nice play from Damn Easy and Breakfast Junior.
Oh wow, at the moment Gibbous are only 5 up. Threat Chess Club should push this right now. They seem to be spamming free choke, they need to follow it up. The combo for Oh, they pop crits! Crits just pop for Threat Chess Club, doesn't get
medic.
Any
staying alive there.
Yep. The combo for Gibbous dropped down underneath the point. They got tossed out by Gapter, who takes down Pippi there.
Oh, really? The soldiers are doing absolute work on this map.
And at the moment, Breakfast Jail is just suiciding in. Oh, yep. To try and get whichever picks he can. And there's a back cap trying to go on.
That's quickly shut down there.
From MJB. Wow, that was a really good play there by Breakfast to try and get a few picks or like some sort of damage when his medic goes down. Now you've got the red combo, including the Devil Man in a choke. Oh, crits is again pop for Azza. And
Balls, it was shot down by the heavy there of Breakfast JR. The right position just to come in and just completely destroy that bush.
Yeah. And now Kippy has switched back to Medigun. Tourette's Chess Club were only 3 up. And
here
come
the rest of Gibbous.
Yeah.
It's only a revolver spy left. It's because all dead rings away.
I've seen some really good picks from Nico and Wilbo to give some windows into Gibbous there. For them to push in, get a few good picks.
There is the power jack being used to kill the sniper para.
Alright, you've got the red combo pushing through Riverside right now, and you've got a level 1 being set up there by Zhao.
Level 2 now.
On the far left side. Kippy is incredibly hurt right now, and Tuba. Underneath the point. They've got their pyro there, they've got Breakfast Jail went down.
The spot. Scout on the point! Oh! So close, they're gonna have to watch that.
That is almost a wipe again from both teams. Both teams only had 2-3 up. What they need to do is Threat's Chess Club need to send like the soldier just someone out.
I think Special K needs to get a bit sneaky here. And he is going down Riverside, but there's just too many.
Yeah, they need to. Yep, Threat's Chess Club have the engineer on the point to make sure that there's no back cap.
People in a source here are calling a spy cap. But
right,
it looks like.
Got 3 on the point from Threat's Chess Club. You've got their scout and a spy up there.
But the.
They should be able to finish this. But there
heavy
are
heavy just standing
underneath.
On the point for Gibbous, just completely blocking it and shutting it down.
Yep, Steve is on half health right now and just wants to finish off this gap.
Oh, he's
out. Can he get
him? No, heavy just turns the corner and just there to block it.
Wow, Kippy there, 40 health.
Got the combo for Chess Club spamming down onto the point now. They've got the high ground and the position advantage. Are they going to try and do something with it?
Yep, Ubers are fairly even, so this will be an interesting exchange.
Oh, but the engineer getting in on the medic! Oh, gets shut down.
As I there, 90 health, that was a really brave play. Oh, wow, that was really brave from, it's mostly about the Gibbous. Their combo just pushed in YOLO through main, just two. And, wow.
There's a heavy on the point. See, he's not going to be able to do anything.
Yeah, that was not the best play there by,
And the Pyro walks onto the point, air blasting people off, but can't get enough time on it.
Oh wow, that's
and the special K just walks onto the point, hits the Jurati players and he's in.
Yeah, like the combo for Tourette's Chess Club was incredibly out of position on top while the rest of the team were back on last. It's mostly about the Gibbous did the same thing when they pushed into last, but they did have best team cohesion, did follow it up with the rest of the team, and Azuz does not seem to be on his game for this game.
No.
Now,
Damn easy getting very fast and trying to shut off the snare push there from Chess Club, but he just gets taken down early by that annoying bulk scout.
Well, Chess Club are playing it really passively, and it seems that it has cost them because now they're currently only four up
and on the wrong side of the map.
Yeah, IMAPG just seem to sort of waltz onto the point, do some damage, and just have just the power bit. Wow, the combo for IMAPG has been pushed up to a four.
Yeah.
Wow.
Incredibly well played.
That's a lot of aggression.
You can really tell why they picked this map.
Yeah, they are quite well coordinated on it. They seem to be moving with confidence.
Oh, definitely. They know the mechanics and where they should be on this map.
I also have a feeling that after three consecutive losses, Chess Club are feeling really unconfident. And you know how...
Well, you can really take a blow to your confidence.
Yeah. You know how half of it is psychological. The Uber for Gibbous is hot. Azuz does not have anything near the Uber needed to contest.
Just focusing the pit class, and now the damage class is only the spy left.
Wow, that's six times on the point right then. That was a really decisive cap.
Is that a 3 out of 4 top frag per round from Breakfast JR there?
Yeah, he
that's
is.
That's quite impressive.
Yeah, he's doing a heck of a lot of work, heavy. As they do say, Gullywash is a really supportive map for heavies compared to other 5CE maps, and Breakfast JR seems to be making the most out of this. Will Chess recover though from this morale blow? Because that was a really decisive 4-0 there. Like, Chess Club managed to cap mid once during all four games. You can really see how losing a few of their main roster can really affect them. Bam. So, what do you think Chess Club did wrong there, and what Gibbous did right, really?
I just think that Gibbous were maybe risking it a bit more. They were going for it. Whilst Chess Club were continuously trying to, you know, play it safe, rely on the damage of the crits from the demo, which isn't really working against a confident Gibbous team.
Yeah. The last round has started. It's currently 4-0 to it's mostly about the Gibbous, and if they win this game, then they win the finals. They win
first map. But it looks like the Chess Club players have been trapped in their elbow for a little bit there, delaying them, but a lot of picks have gone their way. really
Divas
good
are only
play.
Three up right now. Kiki went down fairly early in the mid fight. Wow, this is quite a turnaround from Chess Club. They're really noting turn it down. Breakfast JR there doing a bit of heavy work from Cho. He managed to pick Azza. So that was a really good sneaky heavy play by him. And it does mean that Gibbous managed to push out to mid and cap it when they were three down.
That's...
So they are really relying on picks.
Yeah.
Kippy had about advantage right now. He's building a lot faster than Azza. You can see the blue combo here pushing through big door while the red combo has the high ground advantage.
Yeah, it's going to be incredibly hard to push into that.
Yeah.
They're going to need a lot of work to be done, either with distraction or getting picks from their soldiers and snipers there.
Gibbous have realised this and they've now switched over their team to push into main. Oh, they popped on the Delman. The Delman has to jump.
Oh, he's jumping straight towards the mid there.
Did he get Azza? No, he did not get Azza.
The medic sneaking away. Oh, Kazul coming in and getting the play on Kippy.
Yeah, he is well known for being a really good spy. I think he was third in All Star nominations.
Certainly caused me problems on Viaduct.
And the Gibbous were only four up just then, and that meant that Chester could push back onto the point.
This Pyro just ubered in
the ubered in Scissors, the number two steel Pyro there. He's getting really aggressive. He's incredibly out of position and he managed to get a pick. Will he get another? No, he doesn't, but that was some really sick reflex.
Yeah, really shut it down.
Wow.
Nickel getting the Uber drop.
The control point is being captured. Breakfast JR, they just took down Para and his enemy Heavy. So again, sneaky Heavy from Breakfast JR.
Gibbous are now pushing us back onto the midpoint, but there's a scout behind the medic. Yeah.
Will Steve actually get this pick?
No,
he
doesn't. But in comes Soldier there, Japtar, trying to capitalize on the damage, but... Again, nice dodge from Kippy, get away.
Yep, Kippy got given a sandwich by his heavy and he needs to get some cover. At the moment, Kippy is at 100% Uber, whereas Azza is 40% down. Will they capitalize? Yep, they
now's
are.
The
in the heavy through main.
Here they come. But the Pyro of Scissors there was denying it. Just
oh, Nickel there getting... Another pick on Azza. Azza is just dropping like stones this
dropping
game.
Dropping like Skrillex, the older one.
Yeah, they're leaving Nickel really unchecked. He's really fantastic sniper, and I just have a sneaky feeling that he's outsniping Para.
Oh, Kazul getting the stab on Kippy there. That's gonna make this defense a lot easier for Chess Club.
Yeah.
Well played. But will they have the confidence to come out of the point with the Uber when they get it?
No, or will they, Chess Club need to leave one person on last right now and they need to start pushing out. Yep, that is exactly what they are doing. I'm moving
this. Yeah. Scout there with a mini sentry. Should be fine.
They left it too long. Kippy has respawned. Gibbous should be getting some heals right now. The thing about Gullywash is you wanna do your pushes fast, because it's such a fast map.
Yeah.
At the moment, IMATG have a 50% Uber, and Azza is probably gonna fend this, because Kippy is building incredibly fast, and they only have a 20% window of advantage.
Yeah. They're gonna have to go now.
Yeah.
And even now, it's kind
of
fine.
Do.
They come out. Is Kippy going to get it in time? 96,
oh,
99.
Wow, the combo there for IMATG.
Getting really aggressive. Just, oh, that's brilliantly played.
Yeah, that was a really good play by IMATG. They knew they had a slight disadvantage and they looped around the enemy combo. I have a feeling that Chess Club should have held that instead of pushing out. Well, I'm ATG getting quite cocky there in chat. Showing a great sportsmanship. What do you think of the match, Pinay?
It was surprisingly entertaining, considering the score. And I really don't think that score reflects the game, because it was nowhere near as much as a role as the score would suggest.
Yeah, I'd say the teams are actually more equal in skill, it would seem. Although Gibbous did have a bit of an advantage in this either tiebreaker map.
Well, you could see why they would pick it.
Yeah. Should we wrap it up, Banana? Do you have any shoutouts or anything?
Yes, shout out to Gillen, the medic for Chaos, who asked shout out earlier. And of course, don't forget to purchase some fine quality shoes from Nana and Deox.
Alright, I'm Sunny Starmia. I'm with Banana Man and John on stream. This has been the UGC EU Steel Finals, the third tiebreaker map. Good luck to both Tourette's Chess Club and It's Mostly About the Gibbous in the future seasons. And thanks for watching.
Very well played. Thanks again.